It was written in the stars and in the dust of the dead that from the seed of Gant the Annihilator would come the greatest of all chieftains, Thor the Conqueror, the favorite of the god Tesha. This is the place of the sacred stone of Tesha, where are born the sons of chiefs, and where shall be brought forth Thor, son of Gant the Annihilator. I, Etna, with the fire of the spirit of the dead, purify the symbol of life. Save the infant Thor from Gnut, the faithful archer. And this was a source of great annoyance for Anuda, the ancient witch who collects the eyes of the dead. Many moons times 10 have passed. The earth has changed. The giants of the long nose no longer prowl their jungle. Often and often the sun makes fecund the land, and the earth is the cosmic mother. And here is Thor. He who is destined to be the greatest chief of all. I have raised him as if he were my own son. I taught Thor combat and to follow the path of right and to be cunning. The only thing I have not taught him is my magic. It is all I have left to keep his respect, at least a little. By now he is too big and strong for me.
Old. Etna is old. Eat his fish heads, take no offense. I must face it, it is my time to depart. Time to die. They'll eat their flesh and drink their warm blood.
What's that?
A female.
Female? What's a female?
Yeah.
No, Thor. She's not something to eat. Make her lie down and play with her. What else is she good for? The female is stupid. Have your way with her. Take her. She's yours. Don't treat the woman so gently. And now, Thor, you've known a woman and killed a man. Your reign is about to start, and mine has almost come full circle. Tomorrow is the holy day of Heisha, our god. You've got to go, Thor.
No! Thor, stay right here! Thor has food! And now, Thor has female.
Teisha! Teisha has commanded you. He speaks to you through me. You have to go, Thor, and unearth the blade of your father. And the seed of gold, the fruit that springs from the earth again after the snow. I shall watch over you in the name of Teisha, the god to whom you owe your life.
Thor goes. Teisha!
Mother Death is also life. I'm too old and tired to go with you, Thor. But my spirit will be in the wind.
Thank you.
Warrior virgins?
They are here. This is their territory.
Thor should battle the queen?
If you can get by her handmaidens, yes. You must fight the queen.
Ugh.
It is mine, female. In a world of a man, you will live. Thor, you remember that. All this land belongs to its conqueror, to Thor, your king, by the sacred order of Tay Shah, and you will bear the fruit called children. Huh? You, wait here.
May the trees bear fruit. May the fat animals return. O protector of the seed of gold, accept our sacrifice. Ah!
Oh!
the flame and the blood purify the earth and render it fertile.
Savior as an infant. I failed in my sacred mission. Forgive me, Tisha. What are you waiting for? Aren't you going to kill me?
Golden seed of life. It's the magic of the earth. No! Don't touch it. Only the spirits can.
No. The seed belongs to men, to humans. Tesha orders it. Fire. Stop it.
The lovers resume their journey. They must now traverse the territory of the great buffalo.
Thor comes in peace.
Thank you.
Now the long journey is almost over. Thor and the faithful Ina are about to enter the land of the unknown. In the sands, next to the great water, the Lord Te-Sha has hidden the destiny of the young Thor. I told Thor what it was, but he did not understand. Or perhaps he did not believe it. Ina is expecting the fruit of their love. She is a female, strong and intelligent. A son in her belly. A woman's magic. But there is coming the fateful archer, Gnut, the enemy of Thor.
It is Thor, saith the spirits of the earth, the sky, the water, and those that creep in the underworld.
Te-Sha has spoken to us. I want you to go to Thor. Tell him to come to our village in peace.
Your wish is my command, Odin.
You come. Yes? Bring a...
We welcome and pay homage to you. And I own it. As village elder, declare that from this time on, you are the chief of chiefs.
Thor leads none but the bravest of warriors. Yours is a people of feminine men.
I am an old man and have seen many things. In my life, this is one of the greatest moments. It takes a shaman owner to know one when it comes.
I sense the joy in seeing you all over our village. You come to us as a savior. There has been no rain. For moons now. The animals are bags of bones. Hungry tribes will come to raid our village and take what we have. A little I am willing to share. Only a little, not all.
No, we will give them nothing.
Onid's heart is humble and desires to see men at peace. But Thor is descended from the god of thunder. Kuwasa is the first virgin since the rising of the new moon to reach the dawn of womanhood. She must warm the bed of the chief. Aye, so it is and has been since time began.
So it is and shall be till time ends.
Thor.
Hear me, spirits of the earth, sky, water, and below. The seed of gold of Te-Sha shall render nourishment for all men until the end of time. And thus Thor, the invincible, shall plant the seed and fertilize the earth so that all who follow are his children.
Thor, what is it, Hunter? Misfortune is upon us again. What are you talking about?
Many warriors coming. A great army descending from the mountains.
How near are they?
Less than 5 circles of the sun.
Return, and when they're in striking distance, advise me.
This was not destined to be the great conflict that would alter the course of history. Thor's warriors were not warriors at all. The women inside the huts would have been better. For these men were men of peace, hopeless at fighting a war. Instead, Gnut, Thor's mortal enemy, and the one who slew his father, had seasoned warriors under his command because the earth was dying and offered no fruit. Gnut knew of a land where food could be found and shelter from the cold that was to come, and women, and Thor, the chosen one. But when a man lacks the strength of a lion, he must then utilize the cunning of a serpent. Women are the cunning sex, and Ina was their queen. She had a plan, and Thor listened to her. It turned out to be perfect in its simple logic, the serpent. Gnut doesn't want to kill Thor. What Gnut has in mind is a lot worse.
You, none of them!
Anuda, the witch who collects the eyes of dead men, shall fail to get Thor's. Her collection will be less than perfect.
Tisha.
Spirits that rule the night, spirits of evil. The father I killed, may the son forever go wandering in blindness.
Thank you.
Thank you.
eyes. I can see. I can see again.
Females. You're supposed to be warriors!
Taisha intervened and gave him back his sight.
But he can't kill us as long as we all stick together. You'll have to pick us off one by one. And outside the village. So we'll stay put right here, men. Plenty of pretty little slaves here. We'll let them bring us our water and our lamb.
Thor wants to be chief of chiefs. Instead, Gnut has taken my place. You wander around in the land of the dead. Where is my father's sword? Where is the power of Taisha? I cannot fight alone against so many.
Thor, this creature was sent by Taisha. Centuries from now, he'll be called a horse. A horse adds to your force. He can move faster than the wind. But a horse also likes to run free. He's not going to volunteer to sit under you.
Free for the master.
Han Uda, listen to your son. I ask you to help me. Help me to kill Thor as I killed Gant. I ask you for my sake and the god Wag in the nether regions. Let us expand our forces and let victory be for the powers of darkness till man ends.
Good horse. Good.
Try again.
Oh!
Be good, be good. Good horse. Good. Oh. Go. Run. Run like the wind.
I saw Thor. He was riding a strange beast. It was as big as a hut and going faster than the wind. It was like magic.
Quiet!
Kill us all!
Return.
Bah! Bah! Bah!
Bah! Bah!
Bah!
Bah! Bah!
It's your time. You better get inside. Come. Quick. Hurry.
Please, 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 please,
Stand firm! Cowards! Come back here! Come back!
Thor was the leader of his epoch, but it was not a world in peace. Since then, whoever desires the fruit of the seed of gold need only reach for his plow. But no one has been successful in cultivating the seed of peace.